بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الخلق والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم I greet everyone with the most beautiful greeting The greeting of Islam as well as the greeting of Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has afforded us to have fast 17 days of the month of Ramadan. We are now in the time of maghfirah, a time of forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah ta'ala, may Allah grant us to be of those who will be forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also today we celebrated the day of Badr. The day when history, subhanAllah, it speaks for itself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has proven that we do not need quantity, but we had quality. And those quality amongst the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they were the ones that stood firm to the haqq. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed us that the haqq has definitely prevailed over the batil. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Whether the Quraysh were many in number, a meek amount of men, they came out, and women, they came out, standing firm to the truth. As the Arabic proverb mentions, and it says that, قُلِ الْحَقَّ وَلَوْ كَانَ مُرَّ Speak the truth, no matter how difficult it is, how sour it might be on the tongue, or even if it goes against ourselves, speak the truth, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will aid and assist us. And Allah speaks about the believers in such a way, whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this, subhanAllah, we can just imagine, how the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, how they lived their lives. So simple, simplistic lives they had. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirms in the Quran, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ That indeed successful will be the believers. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ That they who are during their prayer humbly submissive, they humble themselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything that they do, they humble themselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not doing anything ri'a' an-nas to show people what they are currently busy with, or their good actions, or whatever. Al-yadul ulya khayrun min al-yadi sufla. The upper hand giving to them is better than the lower hand receiving. They do everything only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they humble themselves, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam beautifully mentioned to us. Man tawada'a lillah rafa'ahu Allah. The one who humbles himself in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises such a person in rank. Allahu Akbar. What status do we want in this world? What status do we want in the eyesight of people? What status can we actually achieve by people? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being the one that raised us in rank, who can take that status away from us? And that is what we need. We need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to truly look within the pure hearts of our souls. Look deep within our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the intricacies of our thoughts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what is in our hearts. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will judge us according to that. And nobody can see that. And that's the beauty of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us in different tribes in order for us to recognize Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's bounties and favors within each other. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honors a person, mashaAllah, by what? By his taqwa. Who can look into the heart of somebody and say that that person's got less taqwa than that person? That person's got more taqwa than such a person. Nobody can do that, but Allah knows this. So we humble ourselves in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if we do this in prayer, subhanAllah, how do we stand in prayer? We humble ourselves. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ Our forehead goes onto the ground. The lowest of the low we're going, but our prayers will be heard in the highest places in the Samawat, above the Samawat, and that is by the creator of everything. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again speaks to the believers, because when you want to try to humble yourselves, you'll get many, many, many opposition who will say that what is wrong? If you try to come right and you try to do something, normally the comments will come back, he's trying to be pious, what is he trying to prove? All those type of things happens. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He brings calmness over the heart of a believer as Allah addressed the believer, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O the people of faith, لا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. do not listen to the whispers of shaitan. Allahu Akbar. Shaitan, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, who is he? He is an enemy, an open enemy to us. فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. So take him as an enemy. How come we allow him to manipulate us in situations? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not listen to the whispers of shaitan. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us an aql. We should by now know whether things is right or whether things are wrong. If we are on the path of righteousness, on the path of truth, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen for that, we humble ourselves and we make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that. Indeed, if we do that, وَلَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you show gratitude, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase you in that actions. Allahu Akbar. By humbling ourselves in front of Allah. Imagine Allah increase us in that humility. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who are khashi'un, who are the people who with great humility. And may Allah grant us to be amongst them. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on by saying that, and whoever follows the footsteps of shaitan, indeed, he enjoys immorality and wrongdoing. If we do that, we will indulge in wrongdoing. We will indulge in wrong actions. And may Allah protect us from this, because shaitan wants nothing that is good for us. He's looking for companionship in the hellfire. How come we are running towards the hellfire, whereby we have a Lord, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, who's waiting for us to raise our ranks, to be in such a state by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereby He is pleased with us. May Allah grant us to be amongst those rather, inshaAllah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on by saying, and if not for the immorality and wrongdoing, and if not for the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you and His mercy, not one of you would have been pure. Allahu Akbar. Because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, we indeed can perform actions that is good. So even that moment that we do good, we should make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For indeed, if it wasn't for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we could achieve absolutely nothing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to purify us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is trying to purify our hearts. Why? Because as we've mentioned, that Jannah is pure, and it will only accept that which is pure. If we are pure, if our hearts are pure, qalbun saleemun, that is the person that will enter into paradise. A person with a pure and sound heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at our features. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not look at anything. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the heart of a person. Allahu Akbar. May Allah grant us the ability to purify our hearts. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purifies whomever He wills. Nobody can choose. If Allah wills to purify, that will happen to such a person. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is destined that person to be doomed, nobody can do anything to bring that person onto the righteous path. And may Allah grant us to be of those whom Allah purified. And Allah is all hearing, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all knowing. Jama'atul Muslimin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a bit down in the juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us that Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu la tadkhulu buyutan ghayra buyutikum hatta tasta'nisu wa tusallimu ala ahliha dhalikum khayrun lakum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Allah speaks to the believers, and look at the beauty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach us as believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again address us. O you who believe, do not enter houses other than your own houses. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Today, subhanAllah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us in a certain way, we feel that we are authoritative over certain people. We can just move, and we can just walk into their privacy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches that is not the way of a believer. Imagine, just by knocking on a door, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking to the believers. You are amongst the believers, this is how you knock on a person's door. This is the way that you seek permission to enter a person's abode. Allahu Akbar. What a pure deen we have. A deen that teaches everything, even how to enter into somebody else's place, space. This is amazing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not enter houses other than your own houses until you ascertain welcome and greet the inhabitants. So how do we, subhanallah, enter? We say, assalamu alaikum. We have to greet with peace. Allahu Akbar. And that is best for you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. That is how we're supposed to do it. As believers, you don't enter into somebody's space without taking permission from that person and without knocking. Allahu Akbar. And at that moment in time, at the same time, you make salam. You greet that person, perhaps you will be reminded. Allahu Akbar. This is a great reminder for us as believers. Sometimes we err on this particular point. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding us that you are believers. Do this in this manner because this is good for you. This will be great for you. And may Allah grant us to be amongst those people, inshallah ta'ala, who achieve greatness. And whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant to be amongst the best. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa jazakumullahu khairan jazaa. Wa وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته.